All right, let's give it up for the comics who went on already tonight. Woo! Good job. Gosh. Okay, you guys, who here has heard that song, Accidental Racist? All right, not a lot of big country fans in here. Okay, I'm not a big country fan either. That's why I have no idea the name of the guy, because I was too lazy to look it up. Brad Paisley, all right, okay. Because it is in the media for how stupid that song is. Like, Accidental Racist. It's like, oh, by accident, I didn't hire you, but I hired the white guy. Oops. Not funny, but poignant. That's what I'm going for in my comedy. Thank you very much. So I was just thinking, you know, how stupid this whole thing is. What if, what if there was a song called Accidental Rapist? I'm sorry I stuck it in you. I had no idea you didn't want me. Even though you were scratching my eyes out and you shot me in the shoulder. Said, fuck off, asshole. I thought we were playing. I guess I had a rough life growing up, and that just makes me an accidental rapist. Sorry, I fucked you again. Didn't mean to. Thought it was love. Sorry. Guess that makes me an accidental rapist. Then I went to jail. Right, and you were my bunkmate, and you bent over to pick up some soap. Why'd you do that in front of me? You know that's a come hither move. Cause that's just me. I am the accidental rapist. Oops, it happened again. I'm an accidental rapist. Oh no! What's odd is that I never tend to rape myself. Wait, maybe I should sit on a cucumber. Ow! Oh, I'm a real accidental rapist. Just rape myself. Who's gonna come between me and my mental health? I don't know, baby, I love you, but I have an awful way of showing it. Because I'm an accidental rapist. Don't judge. God bless you. Thank you. All right. Genius is happening tonight. Praise the Lord. All right. Okay. So, you guys, It's so right. I'm so right. So, you guys, Halle Berry is 46.
Yeah,
and I'm 45, so I always have to state that. I'm also a year younger than Pam Anderson and Nicole Kidman, who might have had some plastic surgery. I don't know. It's hard to tell. Anyway, but Halle Berry, who's a year older than me, she's got a baby bump, which means that it's okay because I also happen to have a baby bump. Woo! I got my baby bump right here. Hi! Oh... And what I notice is it's less embarrassing to say I'm pregnant than just to say I'm fat. So what I do when I run into like an ex-boyfriend who's really attractive is I just arch my back and sort of like waddle, like, oh, my water's about to break. Oh, hi, how are you? I'm not really this fat. Woo! Anyway, because it's just too humiliating to be fat in LA. Anyway, oh my God. You know, the reason why that joke works, even with skinny people, is that even skinny people in LA think they're fat. So don't anyone steal it. It's a keeper. Anyway, like you guys are going to steal it. Okay, so I have this fashionista thing going on. This is Rachel Zoe. She's got this thing. But this is my version from Ross Dress for Less. All right. Thank you very much. And I just like to call it my like faux pubic hair belt. Woo! Okay, anyway. Oh, you see, you are gay. Because if you don't like women's pubic hair, you're just not into in a way. Okay, anyway. It's weird. Women have pubic hair for like centuries, or at least a few decades. And yet, we're here, so somebody must have made it. Men, we're not afraid to stick it in. That's what I'm saying. But I was thinking, what is that thing called where the wig for the pubic hair that they used to have? A merkin. Okay. Well, when it became fashionable to shave all privy members. I'm just feeling sorry for you merkin makers out there. Because no one wants to buy fake pubes anymore. There goes the family dynasty. Gotta get a real job. God bless you and all of your descendants, those of you who laughed at that. But it's true. I mean, just think when you cornered the market on merkins. Like, what an easy job. I mean, you don't need hair for, like, extensions. You don't need the long hair, you know? You just need a little bit of hair. And you just go, you glue it together and you sell it to people. And they're so embarrassed to buy it that you just over, you know, charge, you know? And anyway, okay. So let's bring back the pubes so that merkin makers can live again and raise their children. Pay for school, live indoors, healthcare. Because we need a good economy, so let's all grow our pubes in protest. Praise the Lord. Okay, anyway. So with that, I just want to say, you guys, it's really fun doing stand-up here. I love seeing you all. And God bless you. Good night. Thank you!